I just want to tell you both, good luck. We're all counting on you.
Chicken salad out of chicken. That's what we are. We chicken. We make do with what we got, right?
Guys, it's episode 27 of Split Decision. It's 27 episodes in, man. Always is with me is Big Kev. What's up, Big Kev?
What's going on?
And our lovable producer guy, Trey. What's up, buddy?
Hey.
And me, Tommy. Bringing you what is this, Offshoots Nation now? The Offshoots Nation homegrown, right. Only homegrown podcast, MMA podcast. We're on iHeartRadio now. Congratulations, Trey.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for getting us to the promised land.
Yeah, if only Pandora and Spotify would have a podcasting service, that'd be even nicer.
In due time, sir. In due time.
This is the promised land. I'm not impressed.
Little short, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it happens. Well, let me start off with the great news. Guess what today is, gentlemen?
The day after Holyfield got his ear bitten off by Tyson.
That is oddly specific. Is it really?
Yeah.
Wow. Good job, buddy. Tops what I was gonna say.
20 years ago.
Wow. Has it been 20 years, really?
Yeah.
Wow. How the hell did you find out that information?
It was on the ticket earlier.
Okay. All right. Well, I mean, thanks for setting me up for failure here. I cannot top that.
I'm here for it.
But it is actually 1 year today. We started Split Decision. We did episode one today.
And we're only at 27?
Hey, man. Hey, you just...
Don't worry about that.
There we go. Thank you, Kev.
I mean, we got half a year in 1 year.
Yeah, a lot of breaks, you know. I mean, we had a holiday break.
It's like Jimmy's recording schedule with the Offshoots,
which is non-existent.
Right.
Well, put it this way: we took a brief hiatus, and we still have came back, and even still have more episodes than the Nigel Rabbit Show. So, how about that?
Wow! Shots fired at Nigel.
Hey, I'm just waiting on a show, buddy. Don't you remember when Nigel Rabbit had a show?
We all are, Petra. Sir.
He's got better things to do, and I don't blame him.
Petridge Farm remembers.
He has GM position duties that he has to fulfill at the MPX. He's really busy.
Yeah, real busy. Can't take an hour out of the day to give us a great show. It's all right. It's all right, you selfish bloke. Dirty redcoat.
He's got conventions to go to.
Right. Ah, true. Well, true.
He has Comic-Con in San Diego to get ready for.
Is he really going to that?
I think Jesse is.
Wow, that's awesome, actually. I can't even knock him on that. That would be freaking sweet.
That's a bucket list item.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, Comic-Con and what's the other one?
Hurricane Harbor.
No, not that good.
International Wildlife Park.
Wow, you went old school. Whoa, I was like 4 when that thing flooded and closed down.
Whitewater?
That one I don't remember.
Sesame Street Park?
Damn. Was that ever a thing?
Yes, yeah. Irving.
It sure shit was. Oh, wow.
I went to summer camp there 1 year.
Wow.
What's up?
All right. I didn't know we were having a pissing contest here. You win.
It's a split decision. That's all we always do. It's either this or fighting over Dolph Lundgren movies.
But there's so many good ones.
Right.
But hey, speaking
oh,
of
of, I'll say real quickly.
Oh yes, take it. It's your show, Trey. Go ahead.
Sure. If you got if y'all want to go on YouTube, there's a 30 for 30 on what would have happened if the Rocky versus Drago fight was real. And they did a whole parody of a 30 for 30 of how Rocky fixed ties between the U.S. and Russia and all this other stuff. It's pretty funny.
That's awesome. Have you seen the YouTube? It's like a little mini documentary about how it paints Daniel. I think it's Daniel Russo and Karate Kid as the bad kid.
Yeah,
as the bad guy. Johnny's actually the good guy.
It made me look at the movie a whole different light.
Me too. When that movie was popular, I wanted to do karate so bad. And when I saw that movie, four or five, it doesn't matter. Anyways, when I saw that movie and he kicked him in the face, even I knew that was illegal. I was like, they're just going to let that slide, huh? All right.
Well, I mean, all that movie was propaganda for was for kids to start doing house chores.
Waxing their grandpa's car.
Right.
Fair enough.
Trent, fan the deck.
Yeah, paint the fence. Yep, catch flies with chopsticks. We all tried.
I wasn't that bored.
Well, I was an only child, so
I was too.
I had to do what I had to do, sir.
That's the point.
We had to entertain ourselves. Well, I wasn't old enough yet. All right, I hadn't discovered the glorious pornographies yet.
The internet hadn't been invented yet.
That is true. That is true. I love telling my daughter when I was your age. Well, I can't say that now because she's 17. But when she was younger, I would say when I was your age, the internet wasn't a thing.
This is a great MMA show, let me tell you.
Hey, it's fun. It's fun. We're fun. All right. But hey, getting back on track here, it wouldn't be split decision without our count ups, right?
Yes.
All right. So I got some new numbers. So, got some new.
Do we have something to count up to or down from or?
We have count ups from that day up, how long it's been.
Okay.
So, I mean, that's all we got right now. Of course, we don't have an official announcement from Miss Rousey, but...
trying to have babies or something?
She's trying. She's trying to have babies with Travis Rousey, yeah.
How's that working out for Travis' wife?
You know, I haven't spoke to either one of them, so I couldn't tell you.
Oh, okay.
But for all intents and purposes, I think we all know she's done with MMA, but she'll probably try to sneak something in here in like a year or two. She'll get some itch, and same thing will happen. Just hopefully she walks away and stays away. But anyways, I digress.
Maybe she went to a decent camp.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, but I think that ship sailed, man. She's getting older in MMA years, and... I don't know. She just can't unlearn those bad habits. She's at a certain point where I think she's just going to have those bad habits, that terrible striking. She's very one-dimensional now. But while we're on the subject, it's also been 182 days since she last stepped foot in that octagon for a whole 48 seconds.
Yeah, you're still a hater.
I'm just reporting the news, sir.
Okay.
I'm just reporting the data. Don't hate me. Hate the data. It has been, in fact, 182 days, and it was, in fact, 48 seconds she stepped into that octagon. Couldn't even make it 60 seconds. You almost had it. Oh, you got to be quicker than that. But we also have Mr. Phil Brooks, better known as CM Punk. I hear rumors. Anytime anybody asks him about it, he says he still wants to fight. I just don't think it'll be in the UFC. But
I think he does want to fight. I don't think the UFC... I think they're just like, get up some kills and let us know.
Yeah, but he was in camp for like 3 years, man.
I get it.
It's too late to the party. It's over.
You're saying he's too old to begin the training?
Yeah, it's over. What is he, like 30, what now? 38?
Like 40-something.
Oh, there you go.
No, 38 maybe?
still. I mean, he's Gandalf in MMA years.
I'm not sure I
understand. Lord of the Ring reference there? Old? Yeah. He's old. He's older.
Okay.
It's also been 292 days since his last fight, which, in his defense, I just want to say, he lasted 3 times longer than Ronda Rousey.
So he's 3 times the man that Ronda Rousey is?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, but let's look at the competition. I think Amanda Nunes may be more than 3 times the man of Mickey Cole.
Don't worry about that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, don't worry about that. Stats don't lie. It's all that matters. It's the numbers. It's the end of the game. So, on this episode, Split Decision, I just wanted to just kind of do a little crossover episode here since it's been, gosh, how many months? When did we last record? Like March? I think it's been March. I think it was late March.
I think Obama was still president.
No, he definitely wasn't. It was March. It was March of this year. So it was March, April, May, June, July. June, July, July. 4 months. Nice little 4-month break, you know. Whatever. But what I wanted to talk about on this episode, a little crossover, since we are in the Offshoots Nation, and it started out in Texas indie wrestling scene. Wanted to have a discussion with yourself, Kev, and your knowledge as well, Trey, of what and the obvious ones cannot talk about the obvious ones yet. Which MMA fighters would thrive in today's WWE, and why? We can't use McGregor yet. That's too easy. And of course, you can't use Rousey because duh.
Chael Sonnen.
Yep, that's a great one. That's a great one. I think Chael would make a great wrestler. Oh, God, just give him the mic. I mean,
right. I mean, he gets the promotion aspect of it, and he's personable where people would like him. So I think he would be really good on the mic. I think he could get over really easily with the fans.
Big country,
huh? Why do you say him other than you know I don't like him?
He's a character, and what do they look for? Characters.
That's true. That's true. Josh Barnett, huh?
I mean, he's kind of in that mold of he understands the promotion aspect of fighting. I mean, he understands the good guy, bad guy, you know, and how to promote. I think anyone who truly understands that.
Mm-hmm.
Could connect with the wrestling audience. And I think those two guys really get it.
I agree. Oh, yeah. There's one that I think would set the division on fire. Just automatically walking in a heel. Joanna Murder.
The only thing that would hold her back is people don't like people, especially in the WWE, she is not the best communicator, and that would hurt her.
You think so? I mean, even as a heel, would she have to be the greatest communicator?
Unless she had a manager who... If she had a Paul Heyman, no.
Okay. I don't know if she'd do well with a Paul Heyman, you know? Who's another good manager? Who could manage her well? I just don't see her with Paul Heyman. Do you see her with Paul Heyman?
I don't mean literally Paul Heyman. I'm just saying she would need a manager.
Gotcha.
Someone to talk for her.
Gotcha. And then she'd just go out there and whoop ass like Brock.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. How, dude, here's one I'm surprised you haven't thrown out there. What about your girl Felice?
I don't she would be a very good babyface, but I think in today's wrestling world, if you can't do both, are you really going to get over it? Like, if that aspect, I mean, why not Misha Tate? I think she would be the ultimate babyface.
Oh, yeah, she'd be, yeah, not to compare her to, but just to give reference to, she would be like the John Cena of the WWE. You just, there's no way you could turn her heel at any point anymore.
What about Luke Rockhold?
He's kind of bland. I think he'd be, you know what, when I think Rockhold, I think he'd be like a great technical wrestler, you know? I think he'd be a great worker. I just don't see him transitioning on the mic very well, you know?
I got one for you.
Yeah?
Michael the Count Bisping.
Oh, all these dirty cheaters in the WWE. Everyone's on fucking steroids. That's my Michael Bisping.
I think he would be entertaining. Yeah.
I can't believe we forgot the obvious. He would never do it, but I can't believe we forgot the obvious, other than Chael.
Who's the obvious?
Nick Diaz.
Either Diaz, really.
Yeah, yeah.
But
I mean,
I don't see, with that tall, lanky build, I don't really see them as being wrestlers. Personality-wise, yes, but body-wise, I just don't see them being wrestlers.
Oh yeah, there's only so big you can get being vegan.
What about Daniel Cormier?
I'll let you take that one, Kev.
You can't really make a living laying on people in the WWE.
Why not? Yokozuna did.
That was just you, sir.
that was you and your rib.
Ribs.
Rib he took with him. Oh, it was multiple, huh?
Yeah. It was bad.
Good job. Oh, was it bad?
Yeah, it was bad. All right.
I thought it was like two or three, or one or two, I mean.
About six. How about Dominic Cruz?
I like that. I like it. I like his mic skills. That would be awesome. He would have to go that. What do they do? The cruiserweights now 205. He would have to go 205 for now, but I could see him actually being the missing piece that makes 205 popular, or at least a person would be interested in 205 if he were there.
Did you watch the Oklahoma City Fight Night?
I actually missed it, but I saw the highlights.
Okay. Dominic Cruz was doing commentary on that. Not bad. It's the first time I've ever heard Dominic Cruz talk and didn't want to punch him in the face.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, I love him. I love his analyst. He's a great analyst. Like, if he steps away today and never fights again, he's got a solid future.
That would be awesome.
In MMA. An MMA analyst. And broadcasting.
Well, they need to replace Goldberg.
Yeah, he was in Bellator. Did you watch any of that Bellator? Dude, I know. I know you watched Chael P. The great Chael P.
What's the P stand for?
The P stands for greatness.
Okay.
That doesn't make sense.
Don't worry about that.
Yeah, it's Chael P. It doesn't matter. He walked away with a W, and Vanderlei Silva was not happy, and it was awesome.
What about Overeem?
Terrible mic skills. He would definitely
and horrible
have
voice.
Yeah, that, exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Okay,
he would have to have a manager.
Then going back to Paul Heyman, would having a Paul Heyman help him out?
Oh, absolutely.
Until he talked, and he sounds like a girl.
Yeah.
That's why he doesn't talk.
He talks like this.
If you put him in a mask and gave him like a Kane backstory of he's horribly disfigured and he can't talk and never took the mask off or anything, maybe. But that's it.
His mic skills would be like, I just want to tell everybody that I am the Ream and I am coming for the WWE Championship.
Brock Lesnar?
Well, once again, for the entertainment aspect that Vince would want to go for, wouldn't that just make total sense for him? I mean, if you get a big badass who's like, can kill somebody, but then he gets on the mic, and all of a sudden, you're like, yeah, not so much, buddy.
Yeah, but he's like worse than Brock Lesnar on the mic in like high voice.
Oh. What about Tim Kennedy?
Tim Kennedy's a character. I think he would be good.
Trey's just Googling MMA fighters and throwing their names out.
He's putting good ones out there.
No, come on. This is all from Fox Sports Net. What about Tom Lawler?
Filthy Tom Lawler, no.
What about Uncle Creepy?
he has
to keep the name.
He's got a built-in name.
Of course. He'd have to keep the name. But, I mean, what would he do? What would he do? Just kind of hop around the ring like a... He'd be like overgrown Hogsworth.
He would be Bailey's stalker.
He's like an overgrown Hogsworth, man. I don't know.
Ellsworth?
Hogsworth. Or what's his name? Hornswoggle.
He's a midget?
He's an overgrown midget, yeah.
Okay. I'm out of names, so...
That's fine. I still have others.
What about,
Well, I mean, Tito Ortiz and Rampage have already done that in TNA.
Tito, oh my god, Tito would be terrible. Tito is terrible on the mic.
Horrible.
Yeah, he can't even put together a coherent sentence. You know who'd be good? John Bones Jones.
You know, it'd be even better if someone got to control their microphone.
Who is that? Is that you, Kev?
You what?
Is that you?
Me what?
You didn't hear that mic noise?
No.
Oh, it's him. If you didn't hear it, it was definitely you. But, John Bones Jones, man. He'd get on the mic, and he'd be like, "What's up, pussies?"
Yeah, I'm sure at that point USA would say, "Yeah, don't put him on TV ever again."
Well, he's John Jones, and it literally would not matter. And then you'd hit Anderson's music, and like, you know how Mike, I can see it now. You know how Mike Awesome has Austin, not Mike Awesome. Holy shit, the Miz. Yeah, the Miz. He says, "Awesome." Anderson's music would hit and be like, "It's Anderson!" And then, like, his music would hit, and then they would have a feud, and it would be awesome. I'd watch that. I'd tune in for that for 6 months. That would be 6 months of solid programming. What'd you say, Kev?
Tell me not to take the drugs!
Yeah. Hi, John Jones! I just Anderson! He'd come out with his Burger King t-shirt. It'd be awesome.
Well, it'd be cool because at that point he'd be at a place where he can do that shit.
Yeah, true. I'd be like, they say Anderson, why you take the drugs? I say, I don't know. I just make my penis go whoop. And then John Jones would be like, "I never told you to take that drug, pussy. It's just because I have a huge cock, Joe Rogan."
And the censors go wild.
Yeah, and then we never see them again.
Exclusively on the WWE Network.
Yeah.
Which is pretty tamed as well, so, you know.
Not if you take off the parental controls, sir. It's a wild night right there.
Yeah, okay.
It's a wild night. Let's see, who else do we have?
Okay, well, on the flip side of that, though. What WWE superstars will make it great in the UFC that are not the obvious ones?
I don't really think of the obvious ones, man. Let's see. Gosh. Obviously, you can't say Ryback.
He's not there anymore.
Well, you still couldn't say him because I believe he was an MMA fighter. If not, he looks like one. Looks like a rip off of Goldberg. Obviously not Goldberg. Goldberg's too obvious too.
Um, Shelton Benjamin?
Shelton Benjamin. Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
University of Michigan.
Yep.
Brock Lesnar's teammate.
Yep. What about Carlito?
No. Where'd you pull that one out?
That's never not cool.
That's what?
That's not cool.
Yeah. Yeah. No, sir.
Dude, gets it.
Give me either one of the Steiner brothers. Give me Rick Steiner. Or no, give me Scott Steiner.
He wouldn't last in the UFC fight.
Rick Steiner of 1985 or Rick Steiner of 2005?
Well, if it's Rick Steiner, he would last. Scott Steiner would.
Scott Steiner.
Oh, give me 2000. I mean, give me. You said 85?
Yeah.
Jesus, were they even around? They weren't around in 85.
Oh yeah, they were.
Are you serious? Oh wow. Give me a early 90s. Scott Steiner.
So you don't want Big Papa Pump?
Just before Big Papa Pump. When he was still a decent wrestler in the ring. When he still had talent.
Big Papa Pump was such money on the mic.
He was, but we're switching. We flipped this. This is MMA.
Yeah, but he can promote the shit out of a fight.
Well, yeah, he can promote the shit out of a fight, but it doesn't matter if you keep getting your ass whooped. And he would just get it. Scott Steiner, late, mid-2000s Scott Steiner would get his ass whooped in MMA.
Well, yeah, because he was huge, but no flexibility, no...
No stamina. Ability. Yeah.
Hey, look, okay, this guy's on the WWE, but we got to see him in Burleson. What about Keith Lee?
I would like to see that. He moves quick for a big guy.
Yeah, he does things a big guy shouldn't be doing.
Yeah, yeah. He moves quick for a big guy. I would see that. I think with the right training, he would actually be successful. He would need training, obviously, but I think he's got the athletic ability to actually be successful, at least amateur. But we are talking UFC, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
I think you could get him up to that point eventually. Yeah.
I mean, if CM Punk can do it, can anyone?
I don't know if that... Yeah, that's a real low bar, buddy. We're playing limbo at that point if we're comparing it to the CM Punk standard, sir. Stepping in the octagon doesn't necessarily mean you made it in the UFC.
Okay. I got one for you. Charlotte Flair.
That would be good. I think Becky Lynch could be badass, too.
She could go all straight fire.
Yeah. I think Becky Lynch would be a badass MMA fighter, women's MMA fighter.
What about Sasha Banks?
No. Not even at strawweight. I think Naomi would be better than Sasha Banks.
Does she get to have the same entrance?
Of course, yeah. Give them all their same entrances. I mean, if that doesn't matter, give them all their same entrances.
I would turn that pay-per-view off so fast.
You don't... Wait, hold on. Hold on, pause. Wait, what? You don't like Naomi's entrance?
No.
It's 10,000 times better than Bailey's.
No, sir, it is not.
Yes, it is. Are you... Oh, I can't believe we're having this discussion right now.
Bailey has one of the best entrances going right now.
No, she has...
Maybe outside of Shinsuke Nakamura.
She has one of the... Now, badass entrance. That one is badass. But are you serious? Bailey has such dumb entrance. With the little...
She has the inflatable Bailey buddies.
The wacky, wavy, inflatable... arm tube men that never work that she has to go by and like pick up three of them. You know why they lean
that
over?
That was just this last week.
You know why they lean over? It's because they don't want to be there, Kevin, and I don't blame them. Because that entrance is stupid.
Best entrance in a long time.
Oh, so totally disagree.
But I don't think Bailey would make a good MMA fighter either.
No, because you actually have to punch someone in the face, and apparently Bayley has an issue with that all of a sudden, even though she's been wrestling forever and wants to be the best.
What about Oksana from NXT? Are you familiar with her fine work?
I'm actually not. I know who she is. I've obviously seen the NXT advertisements, and they show her a lot. And I'm interested, but, like, why haven't they moved her up to the main roster yet?
It's not time yet.
Because she's the only one that's... She's basically carrying the women's division of NXT right now.
Oh, okay.
Because they literally called everyone up but her once they brought Bayley up. And there's no one there who moves the needle except for her and Ember Moon, I think.
Okay. Isn't Ember Moon a local girl?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but the thing with her is that she needs probably another year or so in NXT just to get more accustomed to how they do things. I mean, she came in with a lot of experience already with Shimmer and a few other companies she's worked with, but WWE is a whole different thing, and they teach you not just how to wrestle in the ring, but they teach you the production part of it as well. And that's where I think she's having a hard time grasping it.
Yeah.
Like, finishing the hard camera and all that kind of good stuff.
Right.
Oh, gotcha. Gotcha. What is it about, like, what is, just going off topic real quick, but on topic, what is it about NXT that a lot of the talent just seems to fall flat, and especially when they get to WWE, when they get called up?
Well, a lot of it really has to do with the fact that NXT is, they give you time to do your stuff. You know, you're more hard pressed to get your stuff in on the main stuff, on the main roster, because they've got so much talent there already. They're spreading the show. Once again, they have a 3-hour show. They have a 3-hour show. They can take the time to do it. They choose not to, because they want to keep showing us replays after replays after replays after replays after replays. And they get all in. Once it's not so much the wrestlers getting their stuff in on Raw, it's that the WWE production company wants to get all their shit in on the show. And oh, by the way, we have wrestling too. So,
and oh, we've got to point out what's trending on Twitter. We have to have commercials for the WWE Network. We have to have, you know, we have to recap everything that's happened in the same show 17 times.
Yeah.
That was actually when we first started this podcast of the Offshoots. We that was our biggest concern. And I mean, I actually went through one show one time, and I highlighted every segment. And like, they would, after the first segment, they would show us what happened two other times during the show. As far as like, they would rehash back to the first hour, and it was a lot of that all show long. So.
Wow. Okay. I had a point, but I lost it.
Well, and the other thing about NXT is you're talking about performing in front of 2,000, 2,500 people most nights versus 15 to 18,000 people a night. It's a little bit easier over in a small crowd.
On average, about 8,000 a week.
Yeah, not here lately, right?
Well, I mean, at that Full Sail University, I think they only hold about 2,500.
Right, but if you take WWE house shows along with their live television product, on average they're looking at about 8,000 people a night.
For NXT?
No, for WWE.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm talking about, yeah, and so it's harder to get over with a broader audience.
Okay. But still, I mean...
And a lot of the people that get over NXT, because, I mean, yeah, they do travel for big shows, but almost all the rest of their shows are at that Full Sail Arena, so it's the same people that come in. You know, they have the same core crowd there for all their shows, so it's like, okay, can you get over, you know, I hate to cut it back to, you know, kind of what we do or what we see, but okay, can you get over at MPX? Okay, you know, it took you how long to get over. You know, MPX is a weekly show. This, you know, it's the same core crowd in MPX every show. That's great. But what if you go to VIP or go to NAWA or you go to SOAR? Can you go from one show to another and get yourself over with a different crowd versus, okay, can you establish a relationship with the same people so you eventually get over with the same crowd? But in the WWE, you're not working in front of the same crowd every night. You're working in front of six different crowds a week.
Yeah, and one thing about NXT, they record once a month. So, and they spread their shows out all month long. So, you know, they only have to cater to that audience once a month, like an indie show.
Mm-hmm.
So you, okay. you asked that's what the difference was, and there you go.
All right. So, but my thing is why do they... Okay, but expanding on that, why when they get to the WWE, they get so buried? I mean, the WWE now is so full of just... Everybody's a mid-carder now.
Because you can't,
I can't think of anybody that's like breakout, you know?
Because you can't put everybody in the main event for one thing, and second of all, remember, the higher-ups have their favorites. Okay, it's whoever Vince, and remember, the bottom line stops at Vince McMahon. Who does Vince think is going to push the needle for him?
Yeah.
And unfortunately, in this day of the internet, where people read what Vince wants to see, what do? They boo the shit out of who they want, who he picks out there. Thus Roman Reigns, thus John Cena. And, you know, that's just what it is.
Yeah. I think Braun Strowman would make a good MMA fighter.
Too muscular, not enough flexibility.
Yeah. Oh, here's a good one. What do you think about a Jeff Hardy at lightweight?
Are you gonna let him climb the cage and jump off it?
We'll allow it.
Then I'm good. I'm all for it.
All for it.
Well, you know, and one guy who had said, you know, before in the interview that had this been around, you know, 10 years ago at the time they was interviewed, he would have done this was Undertaker.
Yeah.
Because he was really big in MMA, but it wasn't a thing back when he first started wrestling. So, I don't know if 6'10", 300 pounds Undertaker could do it, but you know, you tone him down to about. I mean, he's still going to be 6'10", but, you know, you get him down to about 250, 260, who knows?
265 weight limit.
Well, there you go.
WWE, or for UFC.
Yeah, 265 is as heavy as you can go for heavyweight.
So Butterbean
wouldn't have a chance. There are some promotions that have some super heavyweights.
Yeah. you know who, we're missing an obvious choice here, guys.
The Big Show?
No. AJ Styles.
Too flamboyant in the ring. Does too many things. He uses the ring to his advantage. I don't think he would do that when it comes to MMA, because the MMA is tight-knit and pretty much lock up and do different things within the hold of each other, but, you know.
You can be flamboyant in MMA. You can have style and, yeah. I mean, look at Conor McGregor. He's flamboyant in MMA, but he gets the job done. I think AJ Styles would get the job done.
I think that would be pretty interesting.
Yeah, I'd tune in. Give me AJ Styles. Give me either one of the Usos. That would be fun.
What about Christopher Daniels?
I don't know who that is.
Kev? Is he any different than AJ Styles?
Yeah, I think as far as striking and I just don't think Daniels would translate. That's just me though. What about Shinsuke Nakamura?
Oh yeah, totally.
How about Samoa Joe?
No.
Yes.
No.
Light heavyweight.
No way. Samoa Joe light heavyweight.
205? It's not that out of the question. Dude, put him... they bill that guy at like 275, but there's no way he's over about 250.
Put him at middleweight. Let's see what happens.
I think 205. I think he can compete at 205.
How about James Ellsworth, 105?
They don't have a 105.
The women's strawweight.
He's already the one.
He's already your first women's Money in the Bank winner.
He is.
Oh, well, until Daniel Bryan took it away from him, bastard.
Did the right thing, man. He did the right thing. I think this talk. Yeah, I think. Randy Orton.
No.
Randall Orton, really? The Viper? You don't think he'd be a good MMA fighter?
No.
Hey, I got newsflash for you. He's not that great of a wrestler either.
He's definitely boring these days.
Here's the thing. MMA requires heart. There's too many times Randy Orton mails it in because he's Randy Orton. And has since he was 25.
Yeah, when you get down to it, the only wrestling he's ever known was OVW and WWE. And OVW was a developmental organization for WWE at the time.
He was not like a college wrestler or anything. He has no background.
No, I mean, he came right from the military right to wrestling.
Oh, he's a military guy? Then
yeah.
Okay, he could probably fight. Unless it was like the Navy or something. No disrespect to her. Any armed forces, Navy people listening? All one of you?
Now, wasn't there something about him... Am I totally making this up?
Yes.
Or was he a deserter? Like...
Yeah, I think he got disarmed with discharge, didn't he?
Yes.
Really? Wow.
Well, that's the only way to find out.
Wow.
The internet knows everything.
All right, well, you look that up, and I got another one for you here. Mojo Rawley. Come on.
If Meathead could do it, I guess.
Xavier Woods would be fun to watch.
Tell Paige about that.
Okay, here we go. After graduating from high school in 1998, God, I feel old. Enlisted in the U.S. Marine Corps. At the base, he received a bad conduct discharge in 99 after going UA on two occasions and disobeying an order from a commanding officer. Under the Uniform Code of Military Justice, he was tried and convicted under a special court-martial, subsequently spending 38 days in the brig at Camp Pendleton.
Wow, you bastard. Yes,
I knew there was something about that. And the WWE, because someone brought that up in a promo, and it was quickly swept under the rug.
I didn't know that. Wow, you learned something new. All right. Split decision. You guys learned something new today. I know I did. I had no idea. Wow.
That's what we're here for.
How long has this show gone today? What, 30, 45 minutes?
Give or take, yeah.
And we're not going to talk about my girl Felice literally beating the shit out of somebody.
Yeah. She did. Did you hear her response though?
Shit happens.
Beautiful.
What else are you gonna say?
I just like how she just was like, shit happens. Like, it just was so confident about it. Like, there's nothing I can do or say about it. Might as well just put it out there.
You know, I was joking with a friend about this, and she's lucky. I think everyone's very lucky that happened with like a minute left in the third round.
Yeah.
Does she walk away if that happens in the first round?
That is interesting. I've wondered that. Like, because I mean, think about it. Think about it. What if she caught Felice in a triangle choke?
Well, or north south, or full mount.
Oof, man, full mount wouldn't be so bad.
You'd want someone with the pants full of shit grinding on you from full mount.
It wouldn't be preferable, but I would definitely. It would definitely.
But Tommy's not against
over-
it.
I'm just saying.
I'm sure we can arrange for this to happen, but.
I'm talking in fight terms, guys. I'm not saying just like freaking on the street, like whatever. I'm talking about in an octagon. Like if I have to do that,
Tommy,
I would rather it
Tommy,
be what?
We can't get it funded, okay?
Alright, fair enough.
Yes, we could.
Have you seen the Craigslist back pages, sir?
I love the dark web.
How's your Bitcoin doing?
Good. What's up?
Fantastic. All that dark web money.
But I mean, literally, yeah.
That's telling him.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it when I because I watched the fights Sunday night, went to bed, and I didn't catch it until Monday morning that had happened.
Yeah, I saw it that night. Well, I saw people commenting on it that night on social media, but I didn't know until the next day. And they were like, yeah, she shit. I was like, oh, no. But
what
on that,
I wonder is if that's something that's happened more.
I'm wondering, was it.
Don't hear about it?
Yeah, it's happened before. Apparently, like, it's not a big deal. What pay-per-view was that where those two people were hemmed up against the cage and that one dude ripped a massive fart? You remember that? Like, they both looked at each other like, was that you? You remember? You don't remember? Oh, it kills me. It was two, and I don't want to call them no-name fighters, but unfortunately, I don't remember. But it was like the mic picked it up and everything. It was clear as day. And they're both hemmed up against the cage.
Huh?
Yeah, and you just hear this juicy-ass fart just... And then they both just look at each other like, was that you? Like, both of them are on the cage. It's hilarious. It is hilarious. I just don't remember the fighter.
The funny part of that would be if, like, yeah, they're in the cage, they're mixing it up. You hear that, and they look at each other, and then they look over, and Herb Dean's like, my bad, had tacos for lunch.
Can you imagine if these fighters had, like, a Mexican buffet, like, right after their weigh-in? Just went to town on some tacos and beans.
What, like, they hit the weigh-in, and then they weigh in, make weight, and they immediately go to ponchos.
And raise
the flag, and...
Just drink the salsa like water.
Bring me a gallon of salsa and cheese sauce, please.
I got to fight in 12 hours.
I got to stop myself back up.
I got to plug it.
Just hope the dam doesn't break.
It's like when a bear hibernates, it creates a plug. Same concept. Now give me the damn queso.
Because, I mean, some of those guys throw, like, vicious liver kicks. What would happen? I mean...
You think it'd be exploding? Just like...
Right.
It would just be instant, just splatter. Oh my god. That's gonna happen one day, unfortunately. And on that day, that week, we will bring it to you here on Split Decision.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Yeah.
Well, and we're also missing the controversy of Mario Yamasaki calling that fight between Piazza and Lee when he never tapped out.
Yeah, you know, I've written, See, the thing
what
is...
What the hell is Tommy be coming here? God.
He's trying to me. And I understand, but...
I think, you know what? Watching it again... I don't know. I think it was a judgment call, because if you actually watch it, it looks like Chiesa goes out for a second.
I never thought he was out because his arms are still moving.
He went limp for a second. That's what I saw. But it was the wrong call. It was the wrong call. But I mean, Yamasaki went in there too quick, so let's get that established. But what I'm saying is I see why he did it. I'm not defending it. Thought it was too quick.
I mean, I understand the choke was deep. And there's no doubt about that. The choke was on. It was deep. He had good position. But,
yeah,
you know, I've seen guys get out of that.
Yeah, yeah. But do you, looking at it now, do you think he would have gotten out of it?
That's not our place to say, I don't think.
I'm asking. It is our place to say. This is a split decision. This is the place to ask those questions, sir.
I think he could have.
See, I love Michael Chiesa. I don't think he would have got out of that.
But I think he deserves a chance.
Oh, absolutely.
If he's willing to go out, and by go out, getting literally choked out and pass out to fight the choke, then you got to let him. I mean, he's making the decision. That's what he's going to do.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. I mean, like I said, it was a bad call. It was too quick. It was too quick. But I think we would have had the same outcome. Now we don't know because, you know, he called the fight too quick. So, yeah, he did mess up, but... Man, I don't know if we're talking about this. If he waits, what, 5 seconds longer, maybe
right,
10 seconds.
Like I said, I think it was in deep, mm-hmm. and I don't know if he would have gotten out of it. I'm just saying he couldn't.
Yeah. Moving along, and speaking of fighters shitting themselves, did you hear about old Hendricks?
Missing weight again?
Yes. And
for the fourth time?
Yes. For you listeners at home, Johnny Hendricks fought at welterweight, which was 170. His last, what, three weigh-ins were at 170, and he missed weight every time. So Dana White forced him to move up to middleweight, which is 185. And this dude still missed it by, what, 3 pounds? Pounds!
188.
Like, that is ultimate levels of not giving a fuckedness. Like, you went up 15 pounds in weight, and you still couldn't cut three? Like, what is going on? Like, does he even care?
He likes to eat.
Do what?
He likes to eat.
Well, clearly.
I mean, I can relate.
Well, you're also not a UFC fighter.
No. But we're not, that's not important enough.
There's some argument Johnny Hendricks hadn't been a UFC fighter in 2 years, but...
That's true. And you want to know when it coincides with?
What?
When the UFC started the USADA testing.
Yep.
I'm not saying he was dirty. I'm not saying he ever did anything outside the rules, because he never got caught, and he's always passed his tests post fight and pre and post fight. Now, what I am saying is, it is awfully, awfully interesting how all of a sudden he can no longer make weight now that USADA. It just so happens to coincide with the USADA crackdown.
Kind of like Vitor Belfort being a viable fighter.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, that's the thing, though. Everyone knew Vitor was on TRT. I mean, he was like Hulk Vitor. Did you see how jacked he was when he was on that TRT? Oh, my God.
He was pretty scary looking.
Yeah, he was. Ah, he was terrifying. I had to check for TRT Vitor under my bed before I went to sleep every night. crazy.
Are you there?
Hey, Tommy, you there? This Vitor. I just prayed to Jesus, and he said you're going to be all right.
Where's the TRT, man?
Yeah. Give me the TRT. I don't need the TRT. I have Jesus.
I thought that's Yoel Romero.
And I... No, I'll do Yoel Romero real quick. But, he's like, I just want the belts. Everyone ducking Vitor, bro. All you people ducking Vitor, bro. that's Vitor. And then Yoel Romero was like, oh, Tim Kennedy, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Tim Kennedy. What is it? Jesus hates gays? What did he say?
I don't know.
No, you remember that? He said something and everyone thought he said Jesus. I don't something like gay Jesus or something. And he ended up saying something completely different. But because of his accent, everyone says he don't like gay Jesus or something like that.
And it was who just, does?
Well, it's just funny that people heard that. It's not what he actually said. It's just his accent so thick. He's like, I'm so sorry, Tim Kennedy. I'm so sorry. I sit on the stool. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I love Jesus. I love Jesus.
Right.
And of course that division is on hold, by the way, speaking of Yoel. He should be fighting Bisping, but I don't know what's happening with that.
Don't worry about that.
Don't worry about that. Yeah. Oh, did you hear the news about 214, sir? UFC 214.
No? Still waiting on 213.
You know, that's a hold on. Oh yeah, Shevchenko and Nunes.
Yeah. Yeah, but the rest of that card's good.
Yeah, Romero Whitaker. Oh yeah, Romero. Yeah. Verdum Overeem. That's actually going to be a really good fight.
Is it?
Wow. This. Yeah, Verdum Overeem. One of them's got to knock one of them out. It's gonna go. It's gonna end by knockout.
Concurrent double knockout.
We almost had that Saturday. Did you see that?
No.
On the Bellator pay-per-view? Yeah. Fedor and Mitrione.
You thought that was almost a double knockout?
No, but it was a double knockdown. I mean, it was the closest thing we got.
Yeah.
I mean, it was just pretty surprising. Number one, it was surprise. It wasn't so surprising that Mitrione knocked down Fedor. Because Fedor's been needing to retire. Like, he should have been gone, like, the past 5 years. You know what I mean? He was never... Fedor has never been the same since Verdum knocked him out back in Strikeforce.
That was more than 5 years ago.
Okay, well, I rest my case, sir.
And he was not good in Strikeforce.
No, he wasn't. He got exposed. He got beat by Verdum. He got beat by, what, Bigfoot Silva?
That was just embarrassing.
Yeah.
The thing about Fedor is he's not a heavyweight. He's a 205.
Oh, easily. He just doesn't want to cut weight.
85.
Yeah. He just refuses to cut weight or doesn't want to cut weight. I don't know. But he just needs to stay out of the cage forever.
I don't know. I wouldn't mind seeing Roy and Nelson knock him out.
Well, you see, did you hear Chael called him out after the fight, after the Vanderlei fight?
Dude, I mean, what do they want to pick? Why does Chael want to pick on an old man?
Because people will tune in, because he's a goddamn genius.
Let's just see this guy fight again. They got beat by someone named Meathead in under 2 minutes.
But you would tune in because
just to see news?
No, just because you think maybe he catches Chael, because if you watch the Vanderlei fight, Chael's chin, I think, is gone.
Well, it's kind of what happens when you get older.
Yeah, but if Fedor connects, man, it's over. And here's the interesting thing. if it gets on the ground like it did when Chael fought Vanderlei, Chael smothered Vanderlei with his wrestling.
Right.
I don't know if you're going to be able to do that with Fedor's, what is it, Samba? Something like that. It's like Russian. It's like Russian jiu-jitsu, basically. It's like Sambo. Sambo, yeah.
Looks at his dad. Says, Dad, I don't want to do hamster style anymore.
It's the same thing that Khabib does now. It's yeah. Sambo.
They need to have someone in the UFC that does that Krav Maga.
No, they don't.
Me
too. No, they don't. You just want to see someone get crushed, don't you? There, dude, you want to see that? Just go YouTube it. There are videos everywhere of MMA fighter versus Krav Maga fighter, MMA fighter versus, my favorite one is MMA fighter versus Gung Fu fighter. Oh my God, he destroys the Gung Fu person.
What is Gung Fu?
Gung Fu is apparently like the grandfather of Kung Fu.
Is it like the Kmart version of Kung Fu?
No, it's the grandpa of Kung Fu. Gung Fu is what Bruce Lee actually did. See, you learned something else here on Split Decision. We are just a paramount of knowledge on this podcast, guys.
Or something.
Yes. But yeah, Gung Fu is basically a lot of it's a lot of hand fighting. It's the weirdest stuff. It's like different traps with your hands and grabs and stuff like that. I don't personally get the point, like what it's for, because that's not how a fight is ever going to go down in any situation ever, unless you're in a Gung Fu tournament.
Or a Gung Fu tournament.
Yeah, I'm just making it up. I don't even know if that's a thing. I mean, obviously, they have to have tournaments because they have belts and stuff, just like any other martial art, so you got to fight against somebody. But I just don't understand the application in real life.
What about an MMA fighter versus a shadow boxer?
Oh, we saw that. We saw that with Rousey Nunes, sir.
Nunes isn't a shadow boxer.
Rousey is.
No, Rousey's a sparring dummy.
Fair with enough.
Stand up skills.
Yeah. Did you see? Oh my God, her shadow boxing is it's the stuff of comedy.
Rousey's?
Yes.
I don't have that much free time, sir.
You don't need that much free time. Like you only need to watch 5 seconds of it. It's like half.
Did Edmund teach her how to do it?
You know it.
Then I'm sure it's stupid.
Oh, it's terrible. It's so terrible.
Ooh, I forgot another MMA star that I think would be a good wrestler.
What's that?
Cody Garbrandt.
Oh, of course. Of course. Oh, I think he's got the full package.
I don't know about his package, but I think he'd be a decent wrestler.
You know, I was expecting that from Trey, sir. I'm surprised you made that comment, Mr. Kev.
I tuned out a long time ago.
Oh. Wow, way to support the show, Trey. Appreciate that.
That's what I'm here for.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, Cody Garbrandt would be awesome, man.
You could always have what's his name be the heel, the snake in the grass.
Oh, Dillashaw.
Dillashaw.
You'd have to change his name to Killashaw though. He'd have to be like TJ Killashaw Dillashaw. Dun dun ch dun 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 ch dun ch dun dun ch, and he would have like awesome wrestling music. So 213 is actually next weekend.
Forward to it.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, I mean, because you got Pettis, you got. Hold on, let me see this card in full here. Yeah, you've got Jim Miller and Anthony Pettis. Showtime. Let's see if we can get another victory, man. I miss. I miss a good Showtime.
Robbie Lawler.
You do, and you have that on the free fights.
That's a prelim fight?
Yeah. Let me double check. If not, it's on 214. I think you might be thinking 214. Yeah, you're thinking 214.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah. That's why I wanted. I mean, 213's okay. I do look forward to the Jim Miller Pettis fight, the Verdum Overeem fight. It's gonna be a toss up. Someone's gonna knock somebody out. Romero should take Whitaker. Nunes should take out Shevchenko. But that's gonna be a fun fight. That's gonna be actually a good fight. Yeah, it's gonna be a real good fight. Let's see. So, let me go to 214 because they announced Cyborg's on the card. She's been on the card, but they made it official. She's fighting the Invicta champ, and I'm trying to pull it up here. There we go.
The champ is here.
No, but we will hear that because John Jones is fighting your boy, Daniel Cormier. I think this is 214 is going to be stacked. I'm looking forward to this fight. You've got Ricardo Lamas on there. You've got Jimmy Manawa. You've got, today it was announced, you've got Tyrone Woodley, Damian Maya for the welterweight title. You got Cyborg versus Tanya Evinger. And then, of course, you've got John Jones in D.C.
Carlton.
I mean, how do you hate that fight? That fight is awesome. I was having a discussion the other day with a friend of mine, and we were talking about how, actually he was talking about how he's it's strange for him to say, but he misses John Jones in the division. And I couldn't agree with him more. Because light heavyweight is so boring now. I'm actually okay with John Jones coming back and laying waste to the division again. I think they need to put him on like a John Jones type schedule where he just goes out, lays waste to the division, goes out on like a 1 or 2 year bender, comes back, lays out the division again. I like it. I like the setup.
Well, he's got to hope he doesn't have to face Gustafson again.
Yeah. I don't know. I think he can take Gustafson this time around.
And the judges just gave it to him.
Yeah. I mean, I hate to say that, but I think he can beat Gustafson this time around. Huh? But yeah, 214 is the one I'm looking forward to. So you got three title fights. I mean, hell, that alone. And of course, you got Sage Northcutt, Super Sage, on the card. Anytime there's Sage on the card, it's always a good time.
Wonder if you went and saw the Power Ranger movie. That guy looks like a Power Ranger.
He does. He does. But yeah, so
MMA,
you know, it's we've been doing this a year, and it's been we're on a 4 month break now. So it's good to be back. It's good to be back. Thanks for sticking with us this long, guys.
And gals.
And yeah, gals. If you are in fact listening, gals, I don't know if any women listen to this show.
And I want to send a special shout out to Norma's cat.
Oh?
I heard Norma's cat's a big fan of the show.
Really? Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for tuning in, Norma's cat.
You're welcome!
Holy shit. What the hell was that?
Apparently Norma's cat's joining us.
Oh, yeah, I can see it now. Somebody's in traffic listening to this podcast on a road trip, and then just they hear Norma's cat out of nowhere, and that person just swerved off the road. Thanks, Norma's cat.
Nowhere?
Is that, yeah.
Norma's cat out of nowhere.
Talk about a move.
NCO out of nowhere.
My God, the humanity! Norma's cat out of nowhere!
Out of nowhere!
That's a damn human being!
Stop the damn match! There's a human being in there! You son of a... Remember when JR used to cuss? He used to get really mad? Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh, you son of a... JR used to get into it.
Indignant JR?
Yes! You son of a bitch! Get out of there! That man has a family! You bastard! Oh, I miss Attitude Era so much.
Yeah.
All right, so let's circle this round and butter this bread here. Let's kick this pig. Let's end this thing. Let's say goodbye. Let's wrap it up.
Bye.
Holy shit. Whoa. So now we gave him exactly enough time to get back on the road, and now we've scared the bejesus out again. Thank you, enormous cat. Thank you. Wow. All right. So from
clean your litter box out, enormous cat.
Yeah. Go tend to your mother, enormous cat. Yep, and that's a cat of not so many words, my friends. So yeah, anything you would like to say in closing?
No.
All right. Any
4th of July? Happy birthday, America!
Back to back World War champs. Better recognize.
I'm a big fan of America.
Me too. I'm a huge America guy, you know.
We all make America great again.
Meh.
Okay. And then you have Trey. All right, guys. Well, thanks for tuning in to episode 27. Next week, we're actually not talking about a certain subject this week because it doesn't happen until August, but. We're definitely going to have a few discussions about this McGregor-Mayweather fight.
That's not a fight.
It's not, but we're still going to break everything down.
It's going to be a boxer versus a runner.
Yeah, and Floyd's the runner?
Yes.
A runner hugger. The dude hugs more than Bailey. So,
you know what? The fight needs a pussy on a pole match.
So does every card, sir.
All right, so on that note, guys...
No way!
Oh, my God. I'm not a fan of Norma's cat whatsoever, sir.
It's not what I heard.
You heard wrong, sir. You heard terribly, terribly wrong.
I'm not dark enough!
It's like I want to be mad, but it's so true. Yeah. You're right, Norma's cat. I like my women like I like my coffee.
So that's the only problem.
I like my women like my coffee. Stupid. I mean, black. So that's the only problem. No, there's other, yeah. No, anyways, we're not doing that. We're saying bye to all the folks in podcast land and thanking them for tuning in, Kev.
There's no one left.
Stick to the script. We've killed them all after the second Norma's cat incident.
They stopped listening at least 30 minutes ago.
Yeah, this one's kind of long. Yeah, we need to, this is way too long. This is, what, an hour, 20 minutes? Yeah, let's wrap this up, guys. Thanks for tuning in.
Peace out.
It's got a lot of power. Bye! You make me feel like a... Mother... You make me feel like a...